The East Coast-West Coast rap rivalry is well known among hip-hop fans, but even on a single coast, there's bound to be some conflict as well. From the Crips, to the Bloods, to the Gangsta Disciples, and more, New York is a hotspot for gangbanging and street culture. Ready to find out which of your favorite New York rappers are Crips, Bloods, or something else? Let's get right into it. Cardi B. The WAP singer has been known as one of the realest celebrities in hip-hop since she always speaks her mind and isn't afraid to say anything. And she has been pretty open about her life growing up in the Bronx, so there aren't many secrets left that she's hiding. When she was a kid in the 90s, she split her time between her parents' place in Highbridge and her grandmother's home in Washington Heights. Both Bronx neighborhoods were run by gangs, and Cardi was just a teenager when she decided to join up. She says, "When I was 16 years old, I used to hang out with a lot of Bloods, and they'd say, 'You should come home, you should turn blood,' and I did." Immediately, Cardi had a family at her back, which helped after her parents split up. You wouldn't know it by her fashion choices or album covers, but Cardi B actually regrets her decision to join up. She says that she reps now because she's been repping for so long already, but in reality, if she can go back and change things, she probably would, especially after seeing how little the affiliation did for her. Stripping made her more money, and so did rapping. In fact, she called joining a gang a scam. You could ask any gang member, being in a gang don't make you not $1. Pop Smoke. Pop Smoke was only 20 years old when he was shot and killed in February 2020, but he had already made a significant mark on the industry. He had only begun his musical career in 2018 after dropping out of high school, but like other would-be rappers trying to get some studio time, he had to find some ways to make money to pay for recording. As he spent a lot of time on the streets, drug dealing was an obvious career opportunity. Pretty soon, he was joining up with the local Crips in Brooklyn. His relationship with the gang hasn't always been easy. He had been pressured by police to snitch on gang members back when he was arrested for having a stolen Rolls Royce in December 2019. Cops asked him to give information on the 823 Crips, GS9, and other notorious street gangs in Brooklyn, but he resisted snitching on anyone. Still, once he got famous, he did change his mind about gangs being a good idea, and he came out to tell kids to avoid them at all costs. Tekashi 6ix9ine. One of the most well-known gang-reppin' rappers alive, Tekashi 6ix9ine has a long history with the Bloods. He was born in New York in 1996 and was raised by his stepfather and mother. When his stepfather was murdered near the house, Tekashi was hospitalized for depression and PTSD. The emotional problems continued and he acted out, which led to him being kicked out of school in 8th grade. Obviously, his now single mom struggled financially, so he picked up a few side jobs to help with the bills. He had all the time in the world now since he wasn't in school anymore, and it wasn't long before he found out that he could make more money selling drugs than he could working at the local deli. He was associating with other drug dealers, getting into trouble, and eventually got caught. He was sent to prison for dealing, and he soon made a few new friends, the Nine Trey Gangsters. This blood set was established in Rikers in prison in 1993. Once affiliated members were back on the streets, they continued membership in the gang and it migrated to the hoods. Tekashi joined up with them while serving a short time in jail and repped them hard when he was released. He was such a well-known member that when he was facing up to 47 years on charges of armed robbery, racketeering, possession of a firearm, and conspiracy to murder, he was able to lower his potential sentence by snitching on all the Nine Trey Gangsta members he knew about. He was a free man in April 2020, not even 2 years after his arrest, and it's safe to say that he might not be welcome back in the gang. Bobby Shmurda and Rowdy Rebel. GS9 was created as a hip-hop collective in 2012 by Bobby Shmurda and Rowdy Rebel. Shmurda was born in Miami in 1994, but moved with his mom to Brooklyn after his dad went to jail. In New York, Bobby started getting into trouble with the law and pulled in a few arrests in a short time. After a while of legal problems, he decided music would be a good path to go down instead. Like Shmurda, Rowdy Rebel also grew up in the East Flatbush hood of Brooklyn. He was notorious in the neighborhood for being a troublemaker as a kid. When Bobby Shmurda decided to check out the rap world, Rowdy Rebel was right alongside him, and together they formed the hip-hop collective, GS9. At first, GS9 was nothing more than a group of like-minded musical collaborators. They wrote music together, occasionally performed together, but most of all, had each other's backs in the industry. Even after signing on with Epic Records, Shmurda and Rowdy kept working with GS9 to help other up-and-coming rappers make it big. The problem with GS9 is that it wasn't as innocent as the founders made it seem. Instead, Brooklyn authorities believed that GS9 was actually a hardcore criminal gang that was taking part in the violence and drug dealing on the streets. In 2014, 15 members of GS9 were arrested with a total of 69 charges, including conspiracy to murder, attempted murder, assault, attempted assault, weapons possession, reckless endangerment, and possession and sale of narcotics. According to police, GS9 were rivals with the Folk Nation and Brooklyn's Most Wanted gangs. Rowdy Rebel has pled guilty in exchange for a lower sentence, and he could be out as early as December 2020. Schmurda was denied parole in September and will not be released before December 2021. Biggie Smalls. The Notorious B.I.G. is one of the most well-known names in hip-hop, despite his early death at age 24 in 1997. He was a Brooklyn native and was out on the streets selling drugs before he was even a teenager. He started performing on the streets with other would-be rappers and musicians and eventually dropped out of school at 17, filling his free time with crime and drugs. It wasn't until he was released from jail on a dealing charge that he got serious about his music. He was soon signed by Sean Combs' label Bad Boy Records when it launched in 1993, and the rest is hip-hop history. Even as one of the best rappers of all time, Biggie is probably known most for his alleged involvement in the shooting death of Tupac Shakur. According to investigators, Biggie may have paid $1 million and provided a weapon to the man responsible for murdering Tupac, a known Blood gang member. It isn't known for sure if Biggie was affiliated with the Crips himself, but we do know that he had enlisted the help of the Southside Crips for the murder and for protection against local Bloods, and that's some pretty heavy gang involvement, even if he might not have been a member himself. 5EO Foreign. 5EO Foreign was friends with Pop Smoke before his passing. As two up-and-coming rappers from Brooklyn, they were also heavy into gang activity. Like Pop Smoke, he's a Brooklyn drill artist that's gained a lot of momentum in a very short time. With his single, Big Drip, in 2019, he started getting more and more attention, leading up to being featured on Drake's track, Demons. In August 2020, he was included on XXL's 2020 freshman class list, so he's definitely a star to look out for. But as a teenager in Brooklyn, he followed the footsteps of hundreds of rappers before him and hooked up with the street gang. He doesn't talk about it much, but in a few interviews, he's mentioned being GDK, Gangsta Disciples Killer. Anyone who's against the Gangsta Disciples can be considered GDK, but it's mostly used by members of the Black Disciples gang. Whether or not 5EO Foreign actually would kill a Gangsta Disciples member on site is unknown. His close ties to Pop Smoke mean that he's probably linked with the Crips set in New York. Chef G. In October 2019, rapper Chef G was banned from playing at the Rolling Loud Festival along with Pop Smoke and three other artists. According to the NYPD, if these individuals were allowed to perform, there will be a higher risk of violence. Chef called the decision mad discouraging, but authorities see the Brooklyn drill scene as a cover-up for violence, drugs, crime, and other gang activities. In a 2018 interview, Chef admitted that the G in his name stands for gangsta. When asked more about what that means, he steps around the question, saying that gangsta is how he lives his life. He doesn't come out and admit being affiliated, but according to several sources, he's a member of an East Coast Crips set. Cormega. Cormega first became known when his name was dropped on fellow NYC rapper Nas' track One Love in 1994. Only 24 at the time, Corey McKay started experiencing fame in the music world. Like other gangbanging rappers, Cormega's rhymes were filled with descriptions of his life on the streets, the violence, the drugs, and the people he's lost because of it all. Even when he started making it as a musician, he had difficulty abandoning his love for the streets, despite all the horrible things going on. Like other rappers and gangs, he's had his fair share of legal issues. He's been locked up for drug trafficking and robbery, and he's even admitted to having shot someone. His name has been linked to both the Bloods and the Crips, so it's likely that although he may not be affiliated with any particular set, he was pretty heavy into gang culture and got as close as he could without actually joining up.